So hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to Creatrix channel. So first of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Vishal Soni and I have cleared engineering services examination 2 times from electronics and telecommunication branch, both times in double digit rank. In 2014, my rank was 98 and in 2015, my rank was 25th. I have served as a Group A Gazetted Officer in Indian Railways and in Indian Telecommunication Services. So most of you must have been following me on the Creatrix channel for electromagnetic field theory. So if you are a seeker of a free education, this is the channel for you. And you must understand that all these free initiatives is coming your way because of the Unacademy. So Unacademy is the revolution in the field of the free education and the affordable education. So how can you access those free courses? So if you want to access the free courses, you must immediately subscribe this channel, Creatrix channel, because all the top educators of the country is providing the free course on this channel. And that free course is absolutely brilliant in content, that is systematic, that is organized, and that is complete. So complete playlist you will be getting of a particular subject. You can develop the concept, you can gain confidence, more than that, you can love the subject. So immediately subscribe this channel. Secondly, if you want to access more free content, then you must immediately download the Unacademy Learners app, because on the Unacademy Learners app, top educators of the country are conducting the free special classes. In that free special classes, you can get topic wise clarity of a particular concept. And do not forget to follow me on the Unacademy learning app. So you can also access the courses. So you must have 2 things. First is your YouTube channel. This YouTube channel, Creatrix YouTube channel, must be subscribed. Secondly, you must understand that you should have the Unacademy learning app. That is must for you in order to crack the examination. So these are the parts of the free education. And if you want to organize your content well, if you want more comprehensive manner, if you want other advantages of the Unacademy, then what are the other initiatives that is running by the Unacademy? So another initiative that is running by the Unacademy is Unacademy Plus. So on the Unacademy Plus, this is very affordable for those who actually want to take their preparation to the next level. So aapko Unacademy Plus mein kya kya milega? You will be getting the live classes on a fixed time so that you can get more disciplined, you can get more organized, and you have something in your mind that at this particular time my classes are going to run. Apart from that, you will get free test series designed by the educator itself. So gone those times when we have lot of errors in the test series, we do not have the discussions of the test series. So there the test series will be conducted by the educators. They themselves will be discussing the solutions of that particular thing. So you can imagine that your preparation is going to the next level for this. Apart from that, those who have prepared themselves for the examination, so for them there are crash courses also available. Again, the crash courses will going to help you in achieve good ranks. Those who have already achieved good ranks and want to improve their rank, for them there are rank improvement batches. More than that, you can also see that there are unlimited practice sessions. So what do you understand by unlimited practice session? Which means there will be various doubt solving sessions. Apart from the doubt solving sessions, there are weekly quizzes, and with the help of those weekly quizzes, you can enhance your problem solving skills. So lot of unlimited doubt solving sessions, lot of quiz sessions, systematic content, structured content. You can download the PDF after the lectures, so you don't have to waste your time in order to making notes. You can utilize those times to practice the particular concepts, or you can use those times to just write down the formulas so that you can remember those formulas quickly. Apart from this plus subscription, there is also one subscription which is known as Iconic. So Iconic subscriptions are for them who actually do not have the self motivation but having the talent. So if they are having the talent and you do not have the self motivation that how can I push myself to crack the examination, so in this Iconic subscription you will be assigned a personal coach. So this personal coach is going to be with you every time, and he will help you to achieve your dreams. You will get a study planner which will be customized for you. You will get the expert guidelines who have already topped the examination. They will be basically hand holding you to crack the examination. So if you think you are not self motivated, if you think you do not have the proper background to crack any particular competitive examination, so this Iconic subscription is must for you. This is going to help you. So if you want the free education, then YouTube channel and the special classes are must for you. And if you can afford a little bit, how much you should afford, that we'll discuss in a while. But if you can afford a little bit, you should come onto this Unacademy Plus. And more than that, if you want the expedited process in your preparation, aap jaldi se exam nikalna chahte hain, jaldi se apni galtiyan sudharna chahte hain, so this Iconic subscription is for you. Then now let us start today's lecture, which is on the communication system. So now let us start the lecture.
Hello friends, welcome to this lecture of communication system. So in the last lecture, we studied about the random variable. We saw the basic definition of random variable and the types of mapping performed by the random variable. Now in this lecture, we would like to discuss few mathematical tools related with random variable. So there are basically two mathematical tools. One is distribution function, another one is density function. So first of all, we will discuss about this distribution function. After that, we will move on to this density function. So in the distribution function category, first of all, we will discuss about this cumulative distribution function. Suppose if x is a random variable, then the cumulative distribution function is defined by capital F. In suffix, we write the random variable, and in bracket, we write the values taken by the random variable. So this represents the representation of a cumulative distribution function. Let us see the definition of a cumulative distribution function. The cumulative distribution function represents the probability such that x is less than or equal to small x, or you can write it as 1 minus probability that capital X should be greater than small x. In terms of any general a, you can write that probability that x less than or equal to small a, or 1 minus probability x greater than a. So x less than or equal to a, we know that it represents the set of all sample points for which x of lambda is less than or equal to a. Similarly, the probability of x less than or equal to a represents the probability such that random variable capital X accumulates all the sample point such that X of lambda is less than or equal to A. So it is basically accumulating all the proper probabilities for which the sample point X of lambda is less than or equal to A. Hence it is known as cumulative distribution function. So the cumulative distribution function is nothing but a probability format in which the probability need to be calculated for all the sample points which are less than or equal to this particular value of small a. Now, let us discuss about the properties of the CDF. So we know that the CDF is nothing but a probability format x less than equal to small x. So obviously, if it is a probability format, so it should lie between 0 to 1. So the value of the CDF lies between 0 to 1, or you can say that the maximum value of CDF is always equal to 1, and the minimum value of CDF is always equal to 0. So from here you can always state that CDF is always non-negative, which means CDF can never be negative. Third important property is value of CDF at infinite. So the value of CDF at infinite can be calculated as probability of x less than or equal to infinite. We know that x less than or equal to infinite will include the complete sample space, so the probability of sample space will always is equal to 1. Similarly, fx of minus infinite can be written as probability of x less than or equal to minus infinite. We know that there cannot be any sample point whose values are even lesser than minus infinite, so in this particular case there will not be any sample point, or it will represent a null event, and probability of null event is always equal to 0. So in the fifth property, you can write that fx of infinite plus fx of minus infinite, it is always going to be 1. Sixth very important property is that the CDF is always non-decreasing in nature. So here non-decreasing means either constant or increasing. So the graph of CDF will always have either increasing value or constant value, or in general we can say that the graph will have a non-decreasing nature. So the nature of the graph can be plotted something like this. Suppose we need to plot any general graph. So we know that at infinite it should saturate at 1, or the value at infinite should always be equal to 1, and the value at minus infinite should always be 0. So the graph should either be increasing, so here I am making the increasing graph, and it should take the value of 1 at infinite. So there can be different formats for drawing the graph. One format may be something like this. This is also your PDF. So I'll introduce some constant nature also. So at minus infinite, it should be 0. And it should either be increasing or constant. And value at infinite should be 1. So this graph is increasing in this section, and it is constant in this particular section. So the overall nature of this CDF will always be non-decreasing. So whenever you will see the graph of a CDF, so you can see the two natures. It may be increasing only, or it may have both natures, increasing plus constant. You can never see the graph of CDF in which it is decreasing in nature. So the graph of CDF has following two important properties. First one is it should always be a non-negative graph. That is, graph should not have any negative value at all. Secondly, the graph should always have non-decreasing nature. Non-decreasing nature means either increasing or combination of increasing or constant. So whenever you have to identify the graph of the CDF, so you should take these two points, and finally the two important points that at infinity it should be 1 and minus infinity it should be 0. So this is very important property regarding CDF. Now the seventh important property is that CDF is always continuous from right, and CDF may or may not be continuous from left. So let us try to understand these two terms. Suppose we have the graph of CDF. So this is the graph of CDF. This value is 1, and suppose this is any point A, this particular point represents A plus, and this particular point represents A minus. So this is your fx of x versus A. So this is statement saying that the CDF is always continuous from right, which means fx of A plus will always be equal to fx of A. This you can always say. Now this fx of a minus sometimes may be equal to fx of a, and in some cases it may not be equal to fx of a. So now let us try to understand when the equality will take place and when the equality does not take place. Whenever step change is present at x equal to a. Suppose the PDF is something like this. So this value will be 0. And it has some step change at x equal to a and finally saturates to the value of 1. So this point is a. Now this point will be a plus and this point will be a minus. Now whenever the step change is present at x equal to a, then it will be strictly continuous from right only and in this case it will not be continuous from left. So this you need to remember: whenever step change is present at x equal to a, then it will always be continuous from right only and it will not be continuous from left. So whenever you need to calculate the value exactly at x equal to a, so you need to calculate the value at a plus. Now the second case, whenever no step change is present at x is equal to a. Suppose the graph of the CDF is something like this. Normal increasing graph, the value is 0 here and it is continuously increasing and finally saturates to the value of 1. Suppose this is your point A, this is A plus, this is A minus. Since no step change is present exactly at x is equal to a, so in this particular case it will be continuous from right and continuous from left also. So you need to take care whether the step change is present at x equal to a or not. Whenever step change is present, it will always be continuous from right but it will not be continuous from left, and whenever step change is not present, it will be continuous from right as well as continuous from left. So in both the cases it is always continuous from right but continuity from left cannot be generalized. Now next, in the next property we will calculate probability in a range. So this is the property number 8. Suppose we need to calculate the probability in the range. So there can be various possibilities of range. So I'm making these four possibilities. The first may be this one. The second may be this probability. Third one may be this one. And the fourth one can be less than or equal to B. So we must understand how to calculate all these types of four probabilities. In first case, the x is lying between a and b but it is not including a. In the second case, it is lying between a and b and it is not including both a and b. In the third case, it is lying between a and b and it is including a only, it is not including b. In last case, it is including both a and b. So I will discuss the first one, then I will generalize all these four properties. So first of all, I would like to calculate the probability such that x lies between a and b, but it is not including the x. So let me make the graph. Suppose I'm making this x less than or equal to b range. So this x less than or equal to b range can be easily understood from here. Now secondly, I want to draw another range, that is x less than or equal to a. So this complete range represents x less than or equal to a, and obviously this point will become a. Now what will happen when I will subtract x less than or equal to b from x less than or equal to a? So I need to subtract these two ranges. So when you will subtract these two ranges, you know that it is also including x equal to a, it is also including x equal to a. And when you will subtract these two ranges, then the inclusion of a will be subtracted from these two ranges and it will become a x to b. Whenever you will subtract this b point here, then x less than or equal to b includes b and x less than or equal to a does not include b. So the subtraction will be 0 and this will include the b point. Similarly, you can write probability of a less than or x equal to b. So this can be written as probability of x less than or equal to b minus probability of x less than or equal to a. So from the diagram you can see that it is also including x equal to a, it is also including x equal to a, and when you will subtract, then this inclusion of a will be removed and the range of x will be from a to b, but now it will not include a because the inclusion of a has been subtracted. So we know that this x less than or equal to b can be written as fx of b, this x less than or equal to a can be written as fx of a, or we know that CDFs are always continuous from right. So the formula becomes b plus minus fx of a plus. So this is very important formula and I will suggest you to remember this formula only. Based upon this formula we will derive the remaining four ones. So the next one is probability of a less than or equal to b. Now how to remember this formula? To remember this formula, what you can do, that you just need to see the equality and inequality. Whenever there is equality on the upper limit, which is b, it will always have this plus sign. Whenever there is inequality at a, it will always include this plus sign. So let me use this formula. So first of all, let us check this point b. Is it having the equality sign? It is not having the equality sign with x. So at b we will use minus. So for x less than b we will use b minus. Now again come to this limit. In this particular limit we need inequality and inequality is present here, so we will use plus sign here. So we just need to check the equality and inequality. Whenever equality is present on the upper limit we will use plus sign, and whenever inequality is present on the lower limit we will use plus sign. So based upon that we will write these terms. So next maybe I can write something like this. Now let us check the upper limit. At the upper limit equality is not present, so we will use the minus sign. At the lower limit equality is present, but we do not need the equality at the lower limit, so at the a also we will use fx of a minus. Lastly, you can write probability of a less than b. Now we need equality at upper limit, we do not need equality at the lower limit. So at the upper limit equality is present, so we will use plus sign here, and at the lower limit the equality is present but we do not need it, so we will use minus sign here. So in this manner you can generalize the results, but you need to remember the only first one. So the trick is that we need equality at upper limit to write fx of b plus, and we do not need equality at lower limit to write fx of a plus. So let me compile all these results once again. First one is probability of a less than a x less than equal to b. Now we need equality at upper limit. At upper limit equality is present, so it will become fx of b plus minus, at lower limit we do not need equality, so we can write it as fx of a plus. Second result, a less than equal to b. We need equality at over limit, so it becomes b plus. We do not need equality at the lower limit, so it can be written as fx of a minus. Third, probability of a less than x less than b. So we need equality at the upper limit, so it becomes fx of b minus minus. We do not need equality at the lower limit, and equality is not present also, so it becomes fx of a plus. Lastly, you can write a less than or equal to x less than b. So in this case, we need equality at over limit, but equality is not present, so it becomes b minus, and we need not equality at lower limit, but equality is present, so you can write it as fx of a minus. So in this manner, you can generalize the result, but try to remember only this one, that we need equality at upper limit and we do not need equality at the lower limit. In that particular case, both are plus. If any variation or any aberration occurs in this case, then change accordingly this plus and minus signs. So this is very important. Now next property, which is property number 9, we have to calculate probability at a point. So to calculate the probability at a point, we need to understand that whenever probability at particular point needed to be calculated, this is your point A. So what you can do, this will represent x less than or equal to A, and the second graph will represent x less than or equal to a minus. So the probability at particular point x is equal to a can be written as probability x less than or equal to a minus probability x less than or equal to a minus. So this particular range represents x less than or equal to a, and this lower range represents x less than or equal to a minus. We know that it can be written as CDF of A minus FX of A minus. All the CDFs are continuous from right, so I can write it as FX of A plus minus FX of A minus. And this results is also very much important, that whenever you need to calculate probability at a particular point, then you can calculate the value of CDF at A plus and A minus. This will give you the probability at a particular point x is equal to A. Now we know that when step change is present at x is equal to A, then fx of a plus minus fx of is not equal to fx of a minus, or we can say that fx of a plus minus fx of a minus will not be equal to 0. So suppose the CDF is something like this. This is a plus, this is a minus. So the probability at x is equal to a represents value of CDF at a plus minus value of CDF at a minus. So we know that the value of CDF at a minus will be 0 and the value of CDF at a plus will be 1. So you can write it as 1 minus 0 or 1, or you can say that this fx of a plus minus fx of a minus will represent this height of this step, or step change. So whenever you need to calculate the probability at any particular point, then first of all you need to check the step change, and the value of that step change will always give you the probability at any particular point x is equal to a. Now in the second case, when step change is not present at x is equal to a, in this case we know that fx of a plus is always equal to fx of a minus, then the probability at any point x is equal to a will always be going to be 0. So in the graph of the CDF, if anywhere step change is present, then probability at that particular point will always be equal to the height of the step or step change. When no step change is present, in all that cases the probability at any particular point will always be 0. So you need to look very carefully that whenever the graph of the CDF contains step changes, then at every step change the height of the step will give the probability at that point, and when no step changes are present, then probability of x is equal to a, or the random variable takes a discrete value x is equal to a, is always going to be 0. Now so this was all about the CDF or cumulative distribution function. So we discussed very important points and some few important formulas. So now let us discuss about the probability density function. So what is probability density function? Suppose x is a random variable now. The probability density function is denoted by small f, in the suffix the value of random variable is written, and in the bracket small x is written, which is nothing but the values taken by this particular random variable x. So this is the notation of PDF. Now PDF is defined in terms of CDF. Whenever you need to calculate the PDF, you just need to differentiate the CDF. So PDF of a random variable can always be written as differentiation of CDF. Now alternatively you can write fx of x is equal to minus infinity to x fx of x dx. Or you can write that whenever you need to calculate CDF, you need to integrate the PDF from minus infinity to x, and here x can vary from minus infinite to plus infinite. So depending upon the value of x, you need to calculate this particular CDF. Now let us discuss the properties of the PDF. So we know that fx of x is non-decreasing function. Non-decreasing function means it is either increasing or constant. So we know that to obtain the PDF, we always differentiate the CDF. So whenever CDF is constant, the differentiation of CDF will always be zero. Whenever your CDF is increasing, then the differentiation of CDF is always positive. So we can say that the PDF will be either greater than zero or equal to zero, or the graph of PDF will always be non-negative. So this is the first property which you should remember, that PDF is a non-negative quantity, or whenever you will draw the graph will always be positive, which means the PDF cannot have graph something like this. This will not qualify as a graph of the PDF, because the PDF is always needed to be positive and it can never be negative. At max it can become zero, but it should never become negative value. Second important property is relation between probability and PDF. Now we know that fx of x is nothing but probability that capital X less than or is equal to x, or it can be written as probability of minus infinite to capital X less than or is equal to small x. And if CDF is known, then PDF can be written as minus infinite to x fx of x dx. So clearly from here you can see that if I just write these two terms, so it can become probability of x less than or is equal to x equal to minus infinite to x fx of x dx. So if I consider this fx as graph, then this whole quantity is representing area under the curve of PDF from minus infinity to small x, or we can say that it represents the range in which probability is to be calculated. So it represents the range in which probability is to be calculated. So if the graph of the PDF is known, suppose this is the graph of the PDF, then we need to calculate area under the curve from minus infinite to x, or in general we can say that area under the curve of a PDF always gives the probability. So whenever you will calculate area under the curve of a PDF in a given range, so it will give you the probability in that particular range. So now if you need to calculate the probability in a range, so how to calculate the probability in a range? Suppose you need to calculate probability of A less than X less than or equal to B. So you know that it can be written as fx of B plus minus fx of A plus. we need equality at upper limit and don't need at lower limit to writing plus sign in both the cases. So it can be written as minus infinity to b plus fx of x dx, minus of minus infinity to a plus fx of x dx. We know that how to write the PDF and CDF relation. So whenever you need to write the PDF, you need to write it in the integration limit. So if I will change the integration limit from here, so this minus sign will become plus, or it can be written as a plus to minus infinity fx of x dx plus minus infinity to b plus fx of x dx. Now we can join these two integrations because the limit here is from a plus to minus infinity and it is from minus infinity to b plus. So these two limits are matching. So we can write it directly from a plus to b plus fx of x dx. And this will represent the probability in a particular range. So here also you can see that when the random variable is lying in the range from a to b, so what we did, we calculated the area under the curve from a to b, and to calculate the area under the curve from a to b, this is your a plus, this is b plus. So this area under the curve is basically giving the probability in the range from a to b. So till now the bottom line is that whenever you need to calculate the probability, so you need to calculate the area under the curve of the PDF. The range of the probability you can always understand from here, and you need to calculate the area under the curve in the given range. Now let us try to write the formulas. So whenever you need to write the probability a x less than equal to b less than a, so you have understood how to write in terms of PDF. So we will use that same logic here also. We need equality at upper limit and do not need at lower limit. So whenever I need to calculate the area under the curve, I will calculate from a plus to b plus fx of x dx. Now try to write the other variations also. Suppose I needed to write this, so we need equality at upper limit, but equality is not present, and we do not need equality at lower limit, and it is also not present. So it will be from a plus to b minus fx of x dx. Similarly, in the third case, you can write probability of a to b. Now we do not need equality at lower limit, so I will start with a minus, and we need equality at upper limit, so I will write here b plus, and it becomes fx of x dx. Finally, the last variation I can write it as, I will write the limit, we need not do not need equality at lower limit, but equality is present, so it will start from a minus. We need equality at upper limit, but equality is not present, so I will write b minus here and calculate area under the curve of the PDF. So these are the four variations which you should take care, and also remember that probability in a range can always be calculated by area under the curve of the PDF in that particular range. So you can note down this point that probability in a range can be calculated by calculating area under the curve of the PDF in that range. So this is very important point. Lastly, probability at a point. How to calculate probability at a point? So we know that the probability at a point can be calculated by using the formula from the CDF. This can be written as minus infinite to a plus PDF of x minus infinite to a minus PDF of x dx. So I can put this minus sign into the limit, so it can be written as a minus to minus infinity fx of x dx plus minus infinity to a plus fx of x dx. So I can join these two integrations because the upper limit here matches with lower limit here. So you can write it as a minus to a plus fx of x dx. So to calculate the probability at a point by using PDF, you need to calculate the area under the curve from a minus to a plus. Now here also you need to understand two different cases. In case one, the graph of the PDF contains impulse at x is equal to. So the graph of the PDF will something look like this. So it is also containing impulse at a equal to a. Now we need to calculate the probability at x is equal to a. So to calculate the probability, we need to calculate fx of a minus to a plus dx. Now we know that the area under the curve from a minus to a plus becomes non-zero only when this particular PDF contains impulse at x is equal to a. So it is containing impulse at x equal to a. So the area will always be non-zero, or it will always give us some probability. Now in the case 2, the graph of PDF does not contain impulse at x is equal to a. Suppose we have another PDF which does not contain any impulses at x is equal to a. So in this case you need to calculate the area from a minus to a plus. So when you will calculate the area from a minus to a plus, the width from a minus to a plus becomes 0, and suppose I am taking this height as h. So the probability that x is equal to a, so we need to calculate area from a minus to a plus fx of x dx, and whenever I will calculate the area from a minus to a plus, it is having height as h and width of a minus to a plus becomes 0, and this probability becomes 0. Since no impulse is present exactly at x is equal to a, so the probability at that particular point is always going to be 0. So from the PDF point of view, whenever any impulse is present at x equal to a, then only probability at x equal to a will be non-zero. And if it contains impulse at x is equal to a, in all that cases if impulse is not present at x equal to a, then probability at particular point will always be 0. So let me summarize these two cases from CDF as well as PDF point of view. In the graph of the CDF, if you need to calculate probability at a particular point, then if it has step change at x is equal to a, then this probability will not be 0, and rather it will always be equal to step change. And if it does not have step change at x is equal to a, In that case, probability at x is equal to a will always be 0. From the graph of the PDF, if we need to calculate probability at a particular point, then if PDF has impulse at x is equal to a, then probability of x is equal to a will not be equal to 0, rather it will always be equal to the area of impulse. And if fx of x does not have impulse at x is equal to a, in all that cases, probability at x equal to a will always be 0. So all these very important properties you need to remember, and in the next lecture we will try to discuss the discrete and continuous random variable and their different parameters.
So if you have liked today's lecture and you want to subscribe to the Unacademy Plus, the very first thing that you should understand that you should use this particular code. What is the code? The code is VishalGate. Write my name and attach gate to it. So by using this particular code, you will be getting all the advantages of the Unacademy Plus. All the added advantages will be directly assigned to you. Secondly, you will directly come to under my guidance, and that will surely help you to crack the examination in the least possible time. And you will also get the guidance of the complete team. Okay. And the most important thing is that you will immediately get the 10% discount on that. So immediately you are enabled to get 10% discount once you use this coupon code. So for example, if you talk about the plus subscription, which is costing you 25,000 for 1 year, and if you use this coupon code VishalGate, immediately you are going to get 10% discount, which is 22,500. And if you talk about the Iconic, for the Iconic subscription of the 12 month, this will cost you around 40,400. So these are the cost of the 12 months. And if you want to talk about the 2 year subscription, 2 year subscription cost of the plus, it is your 27,000 after discount. If you want more discount than 10%, and you have already attended the special classes, then you will be having some credits in your account. Do not forget to use those credits so that you can get more discount than 10%. Now, how can you pay these amounts? So there is one good news for you, that you can pay this amount by using credit cards and debit cards, by using the facility of the zero cost EMI. So if you want to pay this particular amount of 22,500 with the help of zero cost EMI, so the zero cost EMI can be availed by using credit cards and debit cards. Remember, you can use the credit card of any company, but the debit card is allowed for HDFC and the Bajaj Finserv. Apart from that, if you want to directly pay this much of amount, you think that this particular amount is the most affordable fees that can be provided to you for 1 year subscription, so aap directly kya kar sakte hain, you can use this credit card, debit card direct payment. You can also go for the EMI options, okay, and you can directly pay this amount by using net banking. Every time you think of the Unacademy Plus subscription, the first thing that should come in your mind is this particular code. Do not forget to use this code once you take the subscription, because I have already told you that this particular coupon code is going to give you the lot of advantages, so you cannot miss the opportunity to use this code. So every student who want to come on to the Unacademy Plus, they want to take the advantages of the Unacademy Plus, they want to empower themselves in the best possible manner in this digital era, they want to be the part of this revolution, then this is the time for you. You do not have to wait for it. If you are in the first year, if you are in the second year, you are in the third year, the best possible time is right now to prepare for the examination, to dedicate yourself, to give yourself the opportunity so that you can get the success as early as possible. Apart from that, you should also join this GATE aspirant group. So this GATE aspirants group is already having 150k plus students, so you can join it. There are a lot of discussions going on between students, you can get the advantage of those discussions. Okay, you can also join this Creatrix channel, which is a Telegram channel, so everyone has to join this channel so that you can get all the PDFs of the lecture which is being assigned to you. Fine, there are various channels which you can go for it. So various channels in the association with Creatrix, so you can follow the channel of your interest. And this is it in today's lecture. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you so much.